is on the Flexor training system. Basically, I'll give you an overview and then I'll talk about how this specific system was developed. When we look at the neurophysiology of dynamic and static balance, we're looking at three specific inputs of information for the body to try to develop that balance. The somatosensory involves vestibular, okay, so the inner ear telling the body what position we're in. It gives you some, also you're looking at visual cueing where you're oriented in space. And then tactile. Tactile can be the pressure against the foot. It can be the vibration that is going on around you. Anything like that that gives you some sensory input is going to contribute to that somatosensory information that the body's getting. You also have proprioception, and that involves primarily the joint position. Okay, so I know that my elbow is at 90 degrees without looking at it, and what happens, that's especially going to become important with injuries, because with any type of injury, especially the joint injury, it's most severe with severe injuries like torn ligaments, where there's major trauma to the joint, there's a loss of that sensory input for joint position, and unless that's really worked on or developed with people, they will lose that, and that's one input that they're missing that's going to contribute to their sense of balance. Kinesthesia is movement awareness. Obviously, if you break down the definition of the kinetics, you're looking at the movement awareness can be everything from the acceleration or the velocity of the movement of the limb or even the body. It can involve tension on the muscle or tendon itself as the change in position is occurring. You know about the Golgi tendon organs that are giving some input to, they may cause some muscle inhibition if something is happening too rapidly. And so what we want to try to do is take all of that input and try to funnel it into how can we utilize that to maximize our control of balance, and both that static and dynamic balance. When we're talking about sports movements, we're really looking at that dynamic balance and that control of the body to really produce the activity or movement that we're looking for. Now, the Flexor training system relates to a system that was developed by a gentleman named Frank Skip Latella. His primary focus for the last 20 years has really been working with golfers. He has worked with all types of athletes. He's worked with NFL, NBA, NHL, he's worked with Major League Baseball players, but golf is really what his focus and his passion has been, and a lot of what we're going to do today will relate to the golfing movement. But as we talk about it a little bit later, the last of the four movements that we look at is really going to be a sports-related movement. So what we'll do is we'll go over a movement that's specific to the golf swing, but you can make it applicable to just about any movement that you want to. If you're looking at throwing in baseball, if you're looking at kicking in soccer, if you're looking at any type of movement, lacrosse, anything that involves some torso rotation to it, whether it's a stabilization or an explosive movement of the upper body, this can be very appropriate to try to do. His theory is based on proprioceptive exercise. And it utilizes what we have here, a DynaDisc, a little inflatable disc, using the foam rolls and using the physio balls. Now the balls are really only used in that seated position. The DynaDisc is going to be used in just about every position, as well as the foam rolls. But you'll see how that comes together in just a little bit. He based the theory on this whole dynamic on the fact that poor movement patterns and inconsistency of movement were due to lack of balance and flexibility. Now a lot of you are thinking, well, strength is also involved there, and that's absolutely correct. But what Skip was really looking at is that lack of balance, that inability to stabilize, and the limitation in flexibility won't even let you get into the proper position. And then what will occur is these three bullet points down below, the physical restrictions sort of start the chain reaction of compensation. And once the body starts to compensate, you have structures doing things efficiently do. And when that happens, you're always getting into risk of injury. That may mean that you're positioning your trunk in a little more extension than it really should be. You're loading those joints, the discs, the low back, setting yourself up for injury. And if we're talking about high-velocity sports or sports that involve a lot of resistance, getting hit, things like that, running the risk of injury, you're just setting up the athlete for a problem. Movement patterns are dependent on a solid base or learning how to control that sense of support. If you don't have that, you're going to run into problems. And that gets back to that analogy. You can't put a cannon in a canoe. Great to have a bigger gun, but the problem is if you don't have that stability, you're not going to be able to use it efficiently. It's not going to be effective. And then last, this system is unique to the individual. Where I might have Trevor come up and do a movement, and I might have Alex come up and do a movement, they may or may not feel in the same position. Depending on Trevor's deficits or versus Alex's deficits, Trevor may say, you know what, I feel that firing right in my glute, my hamstrings. If Alex is someone who tends to be a little stiff in his upper back, he may say, you know, the first thing I feel is my thoracic extensors firing away, trying to keep me in the proper position. So the nice thing about the balance is it accentuates someone's weakness, and that's where it's going to target their focus on where they're going to feel it most. Something that's near and dear to your heart, is set principle, specific adaptations to impose demands. It allows for specificity of exercise, and what this means is we can take a golf swing and work on that golf swing in the exact pattern that the person is going to perform that activity. We can take a person exploding into their hitting position. We can take someone kicking a soccer ball, shooting a lacrosse ball. Any sport that involves that trunk rotation can be replicated using this. Again, Skip designed this specifically for golf, but we can apply it to just about anything. And or we can take certain components of it, as you see as we go through this, and you can apply it to anything from adult conditioning or even some of the youth conditioning. Proprioceptive challenge magnifies and maximizes muscular recruitment to make remain in balance. If you give someone a challenge to do a certain movement and they have to maintain balance, they're going to be doing everything they can to really maintain the balance while they do that. So it just really exaggerates the recruitment of that muscle to keep them in the proper alignment. If they're not doing it properly, they're going to fall out of position and lose it a little bit. So it's very quick to tell them if they're not doing something properly.